Hello friends, as we are discussing our module 2, that is ecology, today my topic of discussion is habitat and niche. So what actually is habitat we are going to discuss? Habitat, it is according to Odum, habitat is address. And what about niche? Niche is the profession of the individual. Okay. Defining habitat and niche. Habitat, you can say it is a location or mailing address of particular species within an ecosystem. Suppose if an individual is residing in a particular ecosystem, that particular address where that particular species is located, or the location, or you can say address or mailing address, this is the habitat. And what about niche? Niche is the organism tolerance and requirements, or you can say profession of that individual. So in one word you can say niche, it is the profession or an organism, how much it tolerates and requirements which are required by that individual. Okay. So this will give you a brief about habitat versus niche. Any species has a well-defined habitat. Habitat, as I already told you, it is address where it can live, what it needs to eat, and all the breeding grounds. Breeding, you all know. Breeding, water requirements, and so many other factors are also there. Habitat are defined and constant. They are particularly defined area and they are constant. What about niche? Any population of that particular species has a well-defined niche. Niche is basically its occupation, or you can say profession. So a species it interacts with means one species to whom it is interacting. Okay, species it depends on, and the species on which factor they are dependent, and the species that depend on it. Niche can grow and shrink depending on external factor. So many external factors are there, as light, temperature. Next, niche, it can be classified into two groups. Generalized niche, you can also say these are fundamental niche. And second is specialized niche or realized niche. So in one word you can say generalized niche is that the resource an organism or population is capable of using under ideal circumstances. That entire niche that a species is capable of using based on its physiological tolerance limits and resource needed. So generalized, it is the fundamental, you can say in one line, it is a fundamental niche. And what about a specialized niche or realized? A space occupied by the species in the presence of biotic stress. So many biotic stress are present. So resources an organism or population actually uses. What actually that particular population is using, and realize and generalize, that is the main fundamental niche. One thing I want to tell you few more. Two closely similar species having same ecological niche, they cannot coexist for longer time. If two species that are too much closely related or closely similar, or having same ecological niche, they cannot coexist for longer time. And two related species, they may have same ecological niche. Next, through this diagram, you can easily, I have given on x-axis environmental gradient first, on y-axis environmental gradient second, and this is the area that actually is species, that is a fundamental niche, that is without environmental stress. And this is the realized niche, where that particular species is using that particular realized niche. This is the fundamental niche in the absence of biotic stress, and this in the presence of biotic stress. You all have to learn some key points regarding to this realized and fundamental niche. This is the fundamental. So this pie diagram you can also easily understand. So fundamental niche and realized niche. Okay. So key points, all almost mostly fundamental niche is more than realized niche. But some are exceptions, as an example of synergistic partner. Synergistic when they are mutually benefiting to each other. Synergistic. Okay. So in that case, it is vice versa. Realized niche is more than fundamental niche. Realized niche cannot be greater than fundamental niche because of interspecific interactions. So many interspecific interactions are there, and you all know interaction is, it is too much necessary between two species. And competitor species, realized is always less than fundamental species. So fundamental niche, it is basically constant, and realized niche, it is variable. You can say in like this also. This slide is all about generalist species and specialist species. So what actually is generalist species? That is the broad niche. Generalist species are having broad niche, as you can see in this diagram. This one, this is the realized. Okay, this is the fundamental area. So generalized, broad niche, and can live in many different places and less prone to extinction. When something is generalized, means they are in fundamental state, so there will be less chances of extinction because they are residing in so many different places. For example, flies, cockroach, and humans. Second one is a specialist species. They are having narrow niche, and they may be able to live in only one type of habitat, and they are more prone to extinction. This one is not more, this here will be prone to extinct, more prone to extinct. Examples will be tiger. So you have to understand the key point, that as a generalist species, they are having broad niche, residing in different places, and if they are residing in different places, it is obvious that they are less prone to extinction. And just vice versa to specialist species. Through this diagram, you can easily understand, this is on x-axis, it is the niche, that is the range of resources used, and here is the number of individuals using resource. This is the species 1, this is the species 2. Here, a strong competitor, this one is this species first, it is having more competitive power, or strong competitor it is called, and it is weak competitor. This is the fundamental niche, this yellow color area or cream color area, this is the fundamental niche, and this one orange shade, this is the realized niche. Okay. And the niche breadth, it is the amount and range of resource used by a species. How much amount and what is the amount and how many range of resources, these are used by species. And what about niche breadth? This is the niche breadth, and what about niche overlap? So niche overlap, it occurs when two different species share a common resource. Okay. This is all about niche and habitat. It is too easy topic. And through these diagrams, I think you all have easily understand what actually it is. Realized. It is very easy. Means in the presence of biotic stress, or generalized or fundamental, it is in the absence of biotic stress. Okay. Niche breadth, generalist species. These all species between two different species, how resources are utilized, niche breadth and niche overlap. I hope you all have understood this topic very well. If you feel any query, you can write me in comment box. I will surely reply. Thank you. Please subscribe my channel and like this video and share with your friends as more as possible. Thank you once again.